Hi, everyone. Aaron here for zollotech. And yesterday, Apple released macOS Big Sur 11.3 Beta 2 to developers. Now, this is out to developers, hopefully soon to public beta testers by the time you're watching this. It just depends on what time you're watching this at. But this came in at 3.44 gigabytes on my Mac Pro, and it will vary depending on your device. Now, if this is the first time you're installing this beta, it could be over 12 gigabytes. So maybe you didn't install the first beta. It could be a very large install. So just keep that in mind. Now, let's go ahead and take a look at the build number, and you can see if we go to About This Mac, it says version 11.3, and the build number is 20E5186D. And this particular update does add a few new things. So the first thing that it adds has to do with support. So if we go under Support, for example, under About This Mac, click on Support, give it a moment to load, let it collect the data. And as you can see, this is a little bit different than what we had before. So it shows us our Apple Care Plus when it expires. So in my case, December 15th, 2022. And then it has accidental damage, hardware coverage, and 24/7 priority access. We can click on details now. And here it doesn't really do a whole lot for me. And then also get support isn't doing a whole lot. Now, some people will see this pop open Safari, for example, and give you more information. On the Mac Pro, it's not doing that. So it just depends on your device. But for me, it's not doing anything right now when I click on it. And it just gives a little more information about it underneath. So I imagine this will get a little bit updated in the future. But right now, it doesn't seem to function 100%, at least for me. So let's go ahead and close this. And I want to talk about one feature, or two things rather, that I didn't talk about since I didn't do a beta 1 video. And the first one has to do with if you're using HomePods, for example, you'll see we have the option to use them as a stereo pair for our Mac now. So maybe you have two HomePod minis and you want to use them as a stereo pair like I'm using. It works really well unless you're trying to do something in real time, such as edit a video. There's a little bit of lag there. So they added this with beta 1 and it works quite well, like I said. But before, with previous versions, you could only pick one HomePod. So now you have the option for two, which is really nice. The other thing they added support for with beta 1 is PS5 controller support, as well as Xbox Series X wireless controller support. So if you have either of those controllers and you want to use them for a game on your Mac, you can do that with this beta. Now, the next thing they've added has to do with messages. Just like iOS 14.5 beta 2, in macOS 11.3 beta 2, they've added the same emoji to keep up with the Unicode standards. So you can see face in the clouds, exhaling, heart on fire. You have beards for different genders. You've got kisses for different, or hearts for different genders. You also have a syringe where they've removed blood from the syringe. Now it's just sort of a saline solution. And then also you have headphones that have been updated with a new icon that represents AirPods Max. So you've got all sorts of changes here. There will be over 200 when it's released to the public. So this is just to comply with Unicode standards. It's what everyone keeps up with. And Apple is always updating them to comply with those standards. Now, the next thing is music. If we go into the music app, wait for it to open here. Now we're in music. Now in beta 1, they added all playlists, so you can see all of your playlists at once. And they also added made for you with beta 1. And it says personal mixes you add will appear here. Now, for some reason, this is not showing properly for me. And if I go to listen now, for example, it takes a while to load, but we'll give it just a moment. And there you go. And if I scroll down, it's got a made for you section. So it's sort of working for me, but not 100%. And then also you should have some of those playlists that are curated for you here under all playlists as well. So for some reason they're not showing, and maybe we'll see those in the future. Some people are showing it, some people are not. But one thing they have added, so maybe we play a song. Let me go ahead and just pick a song here. So if I click play, and let me drop the volume here. If I click play, and click the three menu button, or the hamburger menu here, as many call it, you've got the infinity symbol now. If we click on the infinity symbol, it will give us autoplay, just like we have on iPhone with iOS 14. And it will find similar songs and just continue playing until you either stop it, and you'll see you can clear this as well. So the infinity symbol is really nice to have here, since it gives you the option to just find similar songs if you just want to leave it playing in the background, for example. So that's something I actually find that I use quite often. And of course, you can turn it off, like I said. So that's new in music with beta 2. So let's go ahead and close that. And another thing you can do now is play WebM videos. So that's a different standard that wasn't available in Safari before. So we'll go into Safari. And I'm not familiar with a bunch of WebM videos, so I haven't had this issue before, but if you go to Wikipedia and search for WebM, we can click on it here, and here's an example of one of the videos. And if you click on that video, you'll see that it actually plays. Before, this would just give you a blank screen and it wouldn't work. So now it works, and you should be able to play those videos. So it's nice that it shows up like that. So that's something they've added in this particular update. Now, they've also added something for M1 Macs as well. Now, I'm on the M1 MacBook Pro, and I had some issues installing this update. So I was previously on macOS 11.2.1, or the public release, and then I installed the beta. For some reason, it defaulted back to 11.1 beta after installing it. Then I did another software update, and it brought me to 11.3 beta 1. Then I had to update again, and it brought me to the current version of 11.3 beta 2 for some reason. So just make sure if you're installing this that you have the same build number that I have here that matches the current version, because I had that issue only on the M1 for some reason, not on the other Macs that I have. So as you can see, we're on the 13-inch M1 from 2020, and one of the benefits of the M1 is you can run iPhone and iPad apps since it's Apple's own silicon. So let's go ahead and open one of those. Now here's the app any.do, and I installed the iPhone/iPad version just so I could show you this because there's some changes in the preferences. So if we go to preferences, you'll see we have touch alternatives here at the top, and we have an option for enable touch and motion alternatives. Now in beta 1, we could enable or disable these individually. Now it's just back to a single checkbox or individual changing of these settings. We also have a new system option as well, and this allows us to enable or disable things like notifications or reminders or access to those things like we would have on our iPhones. So if we open notifications, for example, we can enable or disable this on a per app basis, just like you can on your iPhone. So location services is the same thing. You'll see if we scroll down, we have any.do in here looking for location. So we can enable this or disable it depending on what we'd like to do. So that's new in this particular update. If we go ahead and close this out, there's an interesting change to the code found by my friend Steve Mosier over at Mac Rumors. So what that code suggests is that if you set a calendar event, maybe for a meeting or you need to be someplace with a different address, for example, by the time you're ready to leave, if you've got a MacBook that needs to charge, it will make sure it's charged to 100%. Now, currently, if you go to System Preferences on a MacBook, for example, and on an M1 MacBook, you have battery health. And battery health is maintained by keeping it, if you're leaving it plugged in all the time, that's fine. But basically it learns your daily charging routine so it can finish charging past 80% when you need to use it. So ideally it would keep the battery around 80% to preserve its life over time. And if you have an event, it would be charged 100% by the time you leave. So that's very convenient. There's no physical option for it yet. Maybe there will be in the future, but it's based off scheduling an event in Calendar. Now, as far as when to expect this releasing to the public, well, I wouldn't expect it till maybe March at this point. Usually there's going to be a couple more betas if Apple continues to do things like they did in the past. So expect maybe a new version next week, or we still could be on a 2-week cycle, so we may not see anything until maybe the 3rd. So we'll have to see what Apple does, but either way, I'll keep you updated as I always do. Now, among the new features that I've already mentioned, they've also resolved 15 issues. Many of those were related to developers or those who make apps for the Mac. But the one thing that you can actually test out yourself is if you use the Alex voice for Siri, it now works as expected, where before it wouldn't work properly. So that's working now. So those are all the new things in macOS 11.3 beta 2. If you find anything else, though, I'd love to hear from you in the comments below. And let me know if you'd like to see more of these Mac beta videos. I don't generally do these that much, but let me know what you think about that in the comments below. If you'd like to get your hands on this wallpaper, of course, I'll link it in the description like I normally do. And if you haven't subscribed already, please subscribe. And if you enjoyed the video, please give it a like. As always, thanks for watching. This is Aaron. I'll see you next time.